Heading out.
Apart from an overgrowth of moss, the well looks unremarkable. Dry stones line the wall. At the bottom, something gleams in the dappled light.
Webs everywhere, which means spiders anywhere.
Not a peep. Step counts.
Uh-oh. What is it they say about curiosity and cats? No time to waste.
I have to survive this.
They will know what bit them.
Keeping low, unheard, unseen.
Your throat.
Make way. I'm ready. Moving.
Thank you.
Don't linger. Turn someone inside out.
Surprises. coming through.
Oh.
Better be good.
There's something hiding in that deep unknown. Get behind me. I can look first.
Mind your footing. The bones of the careless are probably littered down there.
Let's chew the fat.
You know, I was just thinking about you, remembering our little encounter in the night. The very same. It obviously put me off your neck, but now I can't help but wonder how the others taste. And not that anyone's volunteered. It's just an idle fancy. Alas. It doesn't hurt to ponder the question, though. Take Shadowheart, for example. She strikes me as having a heavy, enigmatic flavor. Vintage port on two legs. But the Gith, what in the hells would she taste like? Yes, heavens forbid we have an interesting conversation. Still, I am intrigued by the possibilities. Relax. We're just talking. So, in the spirit of theoretical questions, if you had to take a bite from one of them, who would it be? Oh. I'm flattered. Who knew you had such taste? Unfortunately, all this talk is getting me hungry. I better find something I can actually sink my teeth into. Don't tempt me, darling.
Is locked tight with no visible keyhole, only an oval recess in the cover's mouth. You try to examine the book, but the longer you stare, the more those piercing amethyst eyes draw you in.
A cursed book? How obvious. Whoever opens it deserves the fate that befalls them.
Curious. Why don't you take a closer look? I'll observe from back here.
That looks terribly heavy. Why don't you let me carry it for you?
Irresistible. You feel changed, bettered for having opened it. Suddenly you are capable of anything. Felling mountains, darkening suns, conversing with the dead. Glyphs shift gently before your eyes. Words slip into your mind, onto your lips, forming words you don't understand. And something is trying to reply. The symbols move aggressively, probing your mental defenses. Your patron is there to defend you, but there's only so much they can do. The world around you is gone. You can only see those glyphs, only hear those voices. You feel claws moving in the shadows. They pull at you, dragging you closer. Dragging you closer. The glyphs scream, branding your mind with strange runes. You see time rewritten, fate undone, your future thrumming with power. The book snaps closed. You've seen too much. What profane knowledge is now seared inside of you, you should never have known.